Scuba Scoop is sponsored by
tradition on Scoop and Scoop. Every Thursday we try to throw back to something. Well, today I want to throw back to our days in school. And we cannot just say in primary school. No! In even in high school, don't think of Kaunga even at university. So we're throwing back to all of you who went through the Ugandan school education system. Eyo, but guess what? COVID-19 has truly shown us that history repeats itself. Man, I saw the bins that the government was giving. First of all, they are different colored bins. They have weevils. They have all the things that remind me of my childhood. They have what? They also have stones. What is a good meal without stones? Back in school, it had to smell like paraffin. It had to have stones. And the portion never had to be full, like really, really ready. And now given the fact we're in COVID-19, tetuina maanda. I'm just saying. So that's my throwback for today. I don't want to even get into it. I know how I always get into them. For now though, my name is Tinevious One, and of course the show is Scoop and Scoop, and it's proudly sponsored by none other than Coca-Cola. Woo child! So on this beautiful Thursday of a debt we have no clue about because we don't really care, We are living in very weird times. I got up to, I'm trying to check my phone so that I can read the exact tweet that I actually saw. And now Don Wanyama was the first person who brought this to light because I saw him commenting about it somewhere on Facebook. Now, according to CNN, they have this thing they are calling the CNN COVID Heroes and Newsmakers, the Africa edition. Now, amongst these newsmakers and COVID heroes in Africa, they happened to put Bobby Wine, aka Robert Kyagulanyi, aka Sentamu, aka Bobby Wine, as we don't know yet, did they put him as a hero or a newsmaker? Or hero? Like, I think they should have called him an influencer. Now, you people need to understand. I actually took to my Twitter to like really protest this. One, from the very first day when this here beautiful nation reported its very first case of COVID-19, I do not remember anybody else but the Ministry of Health and the government running around like headless chickens. I swear. Now, the days moved forward and different Ugandans came out because now we knew it's a pandemic, it's taking everybody, something bad is happening, we have to unite. People need help, they put us in a lockdown, we started donations, they're giving away things like gorillas. Someone yesterday brought Tokotoko gas. What are we going to use their gas for? Are they going to cook for the people in quarantine? The empty jerry cans, I am still confused because one, that's my sponsor, and I don't think those are the jerry cans he was talking about. Pass on that. But anyway, as the times and you know, the times kept going by, and different people came in to tell us, hey, yo, guys, wash your hands. Different celebrities, because they know that the influence they have is good, they sent them out in huge numbers to sensitize, to tell people, wash your hands, sanitize, stay at home, self-isolate, social distancing. The whole freaking world is doing the same exact thing, right? The days kept passing, the numbers kept growing, and all I kept seeing were three things that were constant. I don't even think they're three, but they're constant things. One, Ministry of Health has been at the helm of this from day one, as in from the jump. Two, my president has not been lackluster in any what way. He is trying his damnest level best with the people around him. Three, now this is the biggest of them all. The medical workers who have not given in to the fear. The medical workers, as you know, TIA, we don't have ventilators in this country. We barely have N95 masks. We barely have protective gear for these people. But day in, day out, they have shown up. They're on that front line. They're at that battlefield and they're like, we're going to do this. Then CNN. Oh, now I understand why Donald Trump keeps calling y'all fake news. CNN comes and of all the people in this here country, and let me remind you, this is not just something regular. We are not a regular country, Uganda, in case you did not know. The US, the Americans, all the other countries are looking at Uganda and wondering, how did we beat this? How are we doing this well? How are we with so many low numbers? They are also in awe. So which clearly states we are doing something entirely, entirely right. Now, Bungamba, Robert Segurani, what is his name? Bobi Wine. If you tell me that Bobi Wine is going to be named as a hero, if you tell me they are going to call him a newsmaker, I am confused. I am confused. Bobi atukoledechi. Agabiobu wunga nebio kuliangabulio muneri lupazo yatu wakubugwe. There is no corona song that makes sense. None. Maybe this girl, there's this young girl, Felista. Hey, she tried. But Bobi Wine sang a song that she says is simple to omu. Kati mhm. Atatege dechi gambo simple to omu mchalo. Eche wa penze jembe hoima. Yele agenda vio gerati. Right? Ofunza kuno ne bebe kuri. Bebe kuri ya bagamba. E namba ya corona ino. Na ajiba somera mubu obutumba. We don't like him, but he did his bit. So, I want to understand the basis that CNN had to actually list Bobi Wine as a newsmaker slash a COVID-19 hero in this my country. Yet he is not anywhere close to that front line. Tarina, yo, the most he has done is come up and say, oh, well, we're finna print out t-shirts with my family and do that popularity thing we keep doing. And then after that, I'm going to go on Twitter with Joel Sonia, and we're going to sit down and think of something to keep the masses talking. Something that should make people feel like I am doing big things, big way. Big way. The best thing you and your team could sit out there and say is, we are going to bring all Africans. Now I saw some, I'm not going to call them dumb people, but I'll just use the word twiddledum for Twitter and dumb. They were there. They were there on my Twitter when I asked what the bestest was, and one was like, Bobi Wine sang a song that is a global hit. Gil, do you know three words in that song apart from symptom? If I held a gun to your head, do you even remember how that song goes right now? But can't you remember? Zero, munana, bid, bid, cause it's annoying. The only thing we remember about that COVID song, or Bobi Wine, is one. Bobi Wine yaluim. Two, yayogera symptom. Three, symptom. Three, mbuyagenda naita other people, but they did two songs. For what, Negro? For what? Someone explain to me how you singing a song to me is finna keep me alive during a global pandemic. So yes, the Spanish influenza is here. What should everyone do? Sing! How is that going to help me? Other than this guy sitting down with his constituents and doing something, I'm tired of you people always covering up for Bobi Wine. He has turned everything into a damn popularity contest. We are talking lives. We are talking people are dying. Real death. And you want to turn this into a popularity contest? That because CNN has your name on speed dial and they know the only loud person they can get. And by the way, this is what makes me laugh at these people. You need to understand the Western world. You will forever be a pawn in a very long con. That is what you don't understand. They will use you, Bobi Wine. They will put you up on all these forums. And when push does come to shove, they are going to drop you like a hot potato. You know why? Because at this particular moment, there is not a near soul, and there is not a single Ugandan who does not want this pandemic to go. So you think we're going to sit here and take you taking such accolades comfortably? No, I say no. I say CNN, for shame, for shame. Y'all shouldn't be reporting about things in Africa that you don't understand about if you can't come down here and figure them out. From the beginning of this global pandemic, in my country, it has been the Ministry of Health, it has been my president, it has been the beautiful people in the medical services, it has been the beautiful Ugandans who adhered to staying home and social distancing. You don't get some cut. Who? Oh, Jesus. Ah, y'all want to get me in a mood. Pretty Betty should not come out today. Like, Now, this is not about me saying I don't like Bobby Wine. I have nothing against him. Politics is his game. For me, politics, it don't matter. At this moment, nothing freaking matters. Who your politics is, where you want your politics to take you, how it's supposed to take you, your trajectory through it. You are not going to use a global pandemic to... At this point, I would actually rather put Omukazi wa Kadala Ewathi Kukalu as a newsmaker and a hero. Because that Mukazi wa Kadala has like 9 kids in her home. She's also scared to die. But she knows there are people out there who also need to eat. She will come out, put her tomatoes there and pray to the Almighty like every Ugandan. They'll pray to the Almighty that they do not die. Na ye gwoliawo osula magere emoto kabaku bugira moto. Kati singa! If this guy is such a hero and a newsmaker, tundra, aina moto kameka, maika emoto kasa bobi ozimanyi. Aina tundra, ogendo tugulire ambulance. That is what my country wants. That is what my country needs, not even wants, needs. As a parliament is about what before you begin shouting and saying, I am taking it back, because for you it's a popularity contest. You could have been a smarter one. You could have gotten that money if they had not put sanctions on it not to touch it. You could have got that 10 million top up on what you had used to buy Posho and buy us one ambulance. That's what we need. You could have used your... Ah, he likes talking to big CEOs. Couldn't you talk to your big CEOs and tell them, oh, guess what? The medical system in Africa is horrible. Can you please donate to us N95 masks, not for the population, just for our doctors? Huh? And respirators, you could have asked for respirators, you could have asked for medication, but you are talking to CEOs about shit you don't even understand. Who is going to open up their airspace to let your people come through? You're going to bring Africans, how? Which country wants to open at this time? How? I'm just angry that the people who deserve the respect, the people who deserve the accolades, the people who deserve our pat on the shoulder and we scream, atta boy, atta girl, are not getting it because there is a guy who has decided for him life is going to be one big popularity contest. Well, guess what? 2021 is coming close. And guess you what? Every near Ugandan who is here at this time, in this moment, if you ask them, who helped you beat a global pandemic? They won't say Robert Kyagulanyi. They won't say Bobi Wine. They won't say he helped me get through this and that. No, they will say the Ministry of Health and the president of this here country and the medical workers got us through that. Don't you dare forget that. And I actually feel mad, Bobi Wine, that you couldn't be meek or humble enough to actually say, you know what, CNN, my bad. I don't think it's my place to speak on COVID in my country, but the Ministry of Health can speak on it. We have documentaries about how we are beating COVID on YouTube without your face in it. You could have actually given that shine to someone else, but no! Ooh, the Slay King you are. You felt like, I'm going to take this opportune moment to also make people believe I am such a star. Mburaga muffin, come politician, oh well. Oh well. All bets are off. I am done sugarcoating Bobi Wine's nonsense. If you people want to come and eat me up, Muchimanyi, you can't. We have to say what we have to say when we have to say it, and I'm saying this now. Bobi Wine, eat some humble pie. Tell your Western media, which I don't know why you keep running to them like as though they're going to solve the problems in Africa from their Western media. Tell them, this ain't your place to speak on none. Tell them, the Ministry of Health or the president of this country can't speak on it, not you. Let's get away from the politicking and politics and move into the things that I think I understand a little bit much better, but I don't. So I was listening to, what's his name? DJ Nimrod was with a counterpart of mine and they were talking about what's happening with Weasel. Your people understand, I always tell you I'll be raw forever. Personally, I'll forever be Radio and Weasel to the death of me. Those are my boys, but Weasel, Baden Saba, Otulo Kalire Blood, you're my person, me like you a lot, but I have to give you some hardcore truth. Now, according to Weasel, his anger comes, he says that DJs are just not playing his music, they don't respect his music. It's around that nonsense. Yabi wogana wogana dana tuwemula ku WhatsApp. Not to City Cup. Personally, I always be empathetic and sympathetic towards the brother. I like it. But because I like you so much, Wiz, I'm going to tell you this. Your music is whack. Your music, I would listen to Baby Shark, do-do-do-do-do-do, Baby Shark. I would listen to that every day than listen to what you have coming out. Now, I'm not just going to be mean like that because I love you. I'm going to tell you one thing. Wizo, lekera wokuyomba ne TV personalities, radio personalities, DJs about them not playing your music. It is one, the music you're putting out is horrible. The music you're putting out is not what you're supposed to be putting out because you forget. You had the good luck or the bad luck of working with Genius and you gave us hit songs while you were with Genius. Now Genius done rested. And we're finally seeing he was the genius and you were not. So I'm just going to give you advice, Wizo. One, get out from under your brother's wings. Because all the music that you have been releasing lately has a bit of a Camille feel to it, which is not your style. Bayo Mulion Island Jokoleda music owerere obane Washington obanani. I'd suggest, here's the thing, before we bash you, I want Wizo to try and go work with a producer that understands his style of music. But better yet, Wizo, take some time out, look for a good producer, but also look for a very good writer. Olave, if you won't give us one song, Ugandans are not that mean, come on. We celebrate Ready and Wizo on a daily. It's not that we don't like you, you're just too much lately. Like you want us sawa binatu berenga tuku sasilolo kubwa, you know, you lost your friend, but yeah, you lost him, we are sad, we are always mourning, you need to move on. Career-wise, either you understand that the music ain't your sh** and you remain the legend that you are. Actually, if I was Wizo, when radio died, I would have stood up and said, you know what, my brother just died, I'm not doing this because I can't do it if I'm not with him. That's it. And I would have concentrated on releasing all the music that we were supposed to release before he died. And then I would live on royalties. That simple. If you feel you cannot stand the pressure in the kitchen, don't get in. Because that's what we're going to do. Tugenda kufumba. Adanze nkutoko seza. Mkwana, I've listened to all your music. No. No. We need to get Atin. We need to get Ray Signature. We need to get... Which other producer is making a lot of waves? Like waves right now. Atin on the beat is the ish. Whenever I hear Atin on the beat, it's a done deal. So let's get you an Atin, let's get you an Oman Rafiki, let's get you Peter Miles. Peter Miles, Wizo, look for Peter Miles. Ask him to write you a sick joint because you're all ragamuffins and he has more, much better lyrical depth. See magic. But see magic, try it. And after this, you can hit me up on my WhatsApp, 12 or 1 on Instagram. We shall keep doing this here in here out. Mchitad. Mbanchari yao, nagataga sane gampita kona emna, it is my job. The girl who looks like an isosceles triangle and lately is wearing her own clothes and looking even worse. Zara Toto. Every blog I am going to is saying you had a fight with your boyfriend. Which boyfriend? Obasajoba changanga chanis. If you know what's Chinese, do you remember that time when they used to call cards Chinese? Hey, Abachanganga Chinese. 1 minute she's with the other one who has a receding forehead. The next minute she's like with the other one who looks like under the bed and as big as this room. The next minute she's coming out of someone else's hotel room. So I beg, these blogs need to come correct with it. When you're telling us the boyfriend they beat, please, take a kachipanani, nerinya, and not just that. We are not going to believe this issue of Zahara beat up someone. For a girl who wears that long fake nails and fake hair, if I was a guy, I don't even have to touch you. All I have to do is pull off your wig. It's enough for her to put her hands down and you run. So I'm not even believing this story. And let's not forget, that particular set of people has a thing for paying blogs to just do stories about them to keep them relevant. So I'm sorry, this whole she beat her boyfriend or did not beat her, I am not going to believe it. Until the guy comes out with a blue eye or a purple eye or, you know, that his hair has grown back to its normal situation. Like cuts. You remember when Fia beat up cuts? We saw the big lip, we saw this, and you know, but at the end of the day, I just want to say, dear my brothers, do not die in situations like this. I know women are violent. That's the thing that we always use for the ones that women always use it, gender-based violence. Well, feminists, here's one for you. Gender-based violence has now moved to the brothers. Who finna say something for them? That's why I kept telling you, the city could say, because I'll never be. Yet I'm a woman, but I'll never be. Because we have wasted so much time trying to raise the girls, we have failed to raise the boys. In a nutshell, the boys are coming out broken, like this one. How do you let a very uneducated thing like that put her paws on you, yet you're paying for her entire existence? How? Would you let that happen? I would even just throw like 200k at your yagala kuba and pa! Kube mtuwala habidi no sirika. Gendo gule wive mpia. Come on. Anyway, the story was, we don't know if they beat him up or not, but we need evidence. I run with it. Okay, still in that line, yo, guess what? This lockdown and quarantine is bringing some beautiful things apparently out of people. Personally, it has not done much for me because I thought during quarantine is when my midsection is going to, you know, that thing, eh? Failed. The tummy is still here. Anyway. Jackie Chandiru took this time out in quarantine to post up a picture of her wearing an engagement ring. And she's like, it's not just tears, it's also tears of joy. I'm like, wait, what? She's getting married again. Excuse me, humans, when I ask, why? Why, Jackie? It's too soon. Wakakusibula kuvamu rehab. The last marriage you were in put you in rehab. What's this dire urgency, this need to always have someone to bank on like that? You need a support system, Siganya, but hey, man, then someone is going to say, Tina, why are you so gripping? I'm actually happy. I'm actually happy for her, because this could be the marriage that... Do you think this is the one that will clean her? Wait, is the guy black or white? Because if it's another white guy, honey, you've been on heroin, they might put you on something like... Meh. Quarantine is confusing so many of you that you've started asking people for babies, you've started asking people Simanya for rings and weddings. Mujakufa will be anyway. Kongs, Jackie, I just pray this one goes well because by God, Jackie, if I hear you have another relapse, I will be the first one to come on national television and put you down like all these Twitter people keep saying, fellow women putting others down. Yes, I personally will put you down. You know why? Because it means you did not look after yourself. You have to first love you. You can't give what you don't have. You love yourself enough to know your body doesn't need syringes. You get what I'm saying? Anyway, that's been my time, people. I'll catch you again on the flip side, which is tomorrow. At Tina Fierce One is my Twitter handle. On Facebook, we are Scoop and Scoop at Tina Fierce One. Not forgetting on Instagram, it's Tina Fierce One with an H. And on Snapchat, it's Tina Fierce One. I'll catch you on the flip side, which is tomorrow. I'm out. Peace.